It was great to sit down with some students earlier because healthcare starts with people, with the workers who dedicate themselves to taking care of others, make sure they get the training, skills, and support they need to give patients the very best care. J'ai eu la chance de rencontrer des gens qui étudient en sciences de la santé un peu plus tôt, des gens qui sont ambitieux et inspirants. Ces étudiants-là représentent l'avenir de notre système de santé. Et aujourd'hui, on est justement ici pour parler de ça, l'avenir des soins de santé au Manitoba. Every year, thousands of people put up their hands to become healthcare workers in Canada, like these students here at RRC. They join the hundreds of thousands of professionals who uphold one of the key promises linked to being Canadian, that no matter where you live, what you earn, you will always have access to high-quality, publicly funded health care. But we have to be honest with ourselves. Even as we take pride in our system, there are some real challenges facing our health systems right now. It can be too hard to access a family doctor or a nurse practitioner. Emergency rooms are too often overwhelmed. People are waiting for the surgeries they need. And healthcare workers are under immense pressure, working in conditions that make it even harder to be there for their patients. The people of Manitoba deserve a system that is there for them, that they can rely on. That's what every Canadian deserves. And that's why last year our government stepped up. We've committed $200 billion over the next decade to strengthen public health care in Canada. As part of this investment, we said we'd work on tailored agreements with each province and territory to help address their unique challenges and needs. And today we're announcing that we've reached our seventh agreement, this one with the great province of Manitoba. L'an dernier, on s'est engagé à investir 200 milliards de dollars au cours de la prochaine décennie pour renforcer les soins de santé publique au Canada et on travaille avec chaque province pour répondre à leurs besoins uniques. Aujourd'hui, on a une annonce majeure pour améliorer le système de santé des Manitobains. Our government will invest $434 million over the next 3 years to help Manitoba. It will increase the number of doctors in the province and recruit healthcare workers for rural and northern communities. It'll make it easier for healthcare professionals to practice in Manitoba, including those with foreign credentials. We'll see reduced wait times at ERs and we'll address blockages and backlogs. We'll ensure people have access to the mental health care they need, including young people. We'll modernize the healthcare system. And we'll be addressing gaps in care experienced all too often by Indigenous peoples. In addition, we're making real investments to improve the lives of seniors in Manitoba, almost $200 million on top of the previous $434 million, which will mean more home and community care and better quality long-term care, including more personalized care for people who live in long-term care. En résumé, on a deux accords avec le Manitoba aujourd'hui. C'est un total de 633 millions de dollars pour améliorer les soins de santé, y compris des investissements dans les soins à domicile, les soins communautaires et les soins de longue durée pour les aînés. On a bien hâte de poursuivre notre travail ensemble pour transformer les soins et pour livrer des résultats concrets. These investments are about delivering real results, about improving patient care and patient outcomes, including for the most vulnerable. Nothing is more important than your health. The federal government is therefore stepping up to make sure that provinces and territories are equipped to deliver the care you expect and deserve, and to protect the promise of our universally, publicly funded healthcare system that is core to who we are as Canadians. La pandémie nous a montré toute l'importance d'investir dans les soins de santé et elle nous a rappelé à quel point les travailleurs de la santé sont essentiels. So I want to wrap up by thanking all the healthcare students here who've put up their hand to do this work. Wob and I just had a great conversation with a number of young people who talked about the calling, the drive they felt to get into healthcare and contribute to their communities, their desire in many cases to be able to take what they're learning here and return to their communities to deliver health care to the families and neighbors that they grew up with. But also we talked a lot about the mental health pressures on our frontline healthcare workers and how governments of all stripes need to do a better job of supporting them, and not just supporting them when they're facing their most acute challenges, but supporting them in a proactive way so people can stay resilient and healthy longer, even in the critically important and sometimes very, very emotionally difficult jobs that they are doing. So I want to thank every doctor, social worker, paramedic, orderly, therapist, OT, the list goes on and on and on, of professionals who step up to serve their communities, to serve their fellow Canadians. You are there for us, and today we're here to tell you that we will be there for you. You keep us healthy, you keep Canada strong, you continue to make Canada the very best country in the world, and we're going to keep working hard to make sure it becomes even better.